Hello guys, it's Deep Shah over here, and today I'm going to show you how to create this simple yet creative text logo in Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool things using Photoshop, then hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So the first step over here we need to do is create a new document. So for that, go to File and then click on Option New. After that, you can set the height and the width accordingly, or else you can set it as follows. And then click on OK. After that, we need to fill this background with that of black color. So for that, click on Create New Fill or Adjustment Layer icon and then select option Solid Color. After that, select the color as black and then click on OK. Now after that, we need to fill this document with that of the main text of the logo, which can be the name of a company. So for that, select Horizontal Type Tool. And then select any font of your choice. Now if you want to download the font I'm using, then the download link for this font is in the description below. Also, if you don't know how to install font in Photoshop, then the link for that is in the description as well. After that, set the appropriate size for the text and then set the foreground color as white, which will be the color of our text. And then click on OK. After that, click on toggle character panel icon. And then set the horizontal and vertical scale accordingly, or else you can set it as follows. After that, click on the document and then type in the first word of the logo. Now if you want to use the swatches like the one which you saw in the thumbnail, then all you need to do is type in the number along with the text. Remember that different kind of number will give the swatches of different kind of lengths. So for this text, swatch of the number 7 looks good. Remember that this swatches only come along with this Crinkis font which I had selected. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. After that, press Ctrl plus T and then scale the text as follows. Press Shift while scaling to scale evenly. Now let me just bring it to the center. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. Now after that, I need to type in the second word of the text below this swatch over here. So for that, click on the document and then type in the second word of the text. I want to keep this second word in all caps. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. After that, press Ctrl plus T and then scale the text as follows. After that, let me just move this text below this swatch over here. Now to blend the text properly with that of the swatch, let me just skew the text a little bit. So for that, right click inside of the text and then select option skew. After that, skew it by little. So this looks proper. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. So now let's merge this two text layer into a single group. So for that, press Ctrl and click on the text layer below it, which will give you the selection of that text layer as well as keep the selection of the current text layer. After that, press Ctrl plus G to merge the two selected layers into a single group. Now let's rename this group as text. After that, we need to skew the whole text a little bit to make it look more proper. So for that, press Ctrl plus T and then right click over there and then select option skew. After that, skew it a little bit as follows. This looks proper. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. So now as you can see, the main text of the logo, which is the name of the company, is now ready. Now let's create a ring surrounding this text, inside which we can place some another text. So for that, select ellipse tool and then set the fill as no fill, color of the stroke as white, and then set the size of the stroke to 3 point. After that, set the stroke as full stroke and then click on the document and then set the height and the width of the ellipse as 847 pixels. After that, click on OK. Now after that, we need to place this ellipse at the center of the document. So for that, press Ctrl and click on the background layer. After that, select move tool. After that, click on align vertical centers and then click on align horizontal centers. After that, again make the ellipse layer active by clicking on it. And then again select the ellipse tool. So this circle will be the outer portion of the ring. After that, we need to create the inner portion as well. So for that, again click on the document and then type in the width and the height of the document as 691 pixels. After that, click on OK. Now place this ellipse at the center of the document as well. So now as you can see, our ring is now ready. Now let's rename this ellipse layer as follows. The top layer as inner ring layer and then the second layer as outer ring. After that, we need to place this text properly inside of the ring. So for that, make the text group layer active by clicking on it. And then select move tool, and then using move tool, place the text properly. So now this looks proper. After that, we need to merge the two ellipse layer into a single group. So for that, make the inner ring layer active by clicking on it. After that, press Ctrl and click on the outer ring layer, and then press Ctrl plus G. Now let's rename this group as ring. After that, we need to create three dotted circles inside of the ring over here to make it look more better. So for that, select ellipse tool and then set the fill as no fill, color of the stroke as white, and then the size of the stroke as 0.5 point, and then set the shape of the stroke as dotted. After that, click on the document and then type in the height and the width of the ellipse as 739 pixels. After that, click on OK. Now place this dotted circle at the center of the document. After that, make the ellipse layer active, and then let's rename this layer as inner ring dotted. So like this way, we need to create two more dotted circles, which will be the middle circle and then the other will be the outer circle. I'm setting the height and the width of the middle circle as 775 pixels. Setting the height and the width of the third circle as 811 pixels. So now as you can see, we have created the three dotted circles inside of the ring over here. Now let's merge these three layers into a single group. So for that, press shift and click on the inner ring dotted layer. After that, press Ctrl plus G. Now let's rename this group layer as ring dotted. So as you can see, the inner portion of the ring where the text is present is looking somewhat plain. So let me just create two more circles inside of the ring. One will be a plain circle and the other will be a dotted one. Let me just increase the size for the plain circle to 3 point. After that, click on the document and then type in the width and the height of the document as 591 pixels. And then place it at the center of the document. Now let me just merge the two inner circles, that is the plain circle and the dotted circle, into a single group. And let's rename that group as inner. So now as you can see, now it is looking proper. Now let's merge all of the ellipse group layer into a single group. So for that, press shift and click on the ring group layer, which will give you the selection of ring group layer, as well as keep the selection of inner group layer and give you the selection of all the groups in between. After that, press Ctrl plus G to merge all the groups into a single group. Now let's rename this group as ellipse. Now after that, I want that there should be some space between the intersection of the text and the circle over here, which will make the text completely visible. So for that, make the text layer active by clicking on it, and then drag the text layer above the ellipse layer, and then click on add layer style icon, and then select option stroke. After that, set the color of the stroke as the color of the background, which is black over here, and then set the size of the stroke as 15 pixels, position as outside, blend mode as normal, and opacity as 100%. After that, click on OK. So now as you can see, the text is now completely visible and it is looking good. But there is one problem by keeping it as a stroke over here, which is that if we want to change the color of the background, we will have to change the color of the stroke as well. Now in order to solve that thing, let's create a layer out of the stroke. So for that, right click on the effects and then select option create layer. So now as you can see, a new layer has been created with that of the stroke of the text. Now we need to get the selection of the stroke. So for that, press Ctrl and click on the icon of the stroke layer, which will give you the selection of that stroke. After that, make the ellipse layer active by clicking on it, and then click on add layer mask icon. After that, press Ctrl plus I to invert the mask. Now after that, hide the text stroke layer by clicking on the icon. So now even if you change the color of the background, it won't be of any issue. Now after that, I want to type in the text inside of the ring over here, which will be in the form of a circle. So for that, expand the ellipse group layer and then expand the ring group layer, and then make the inner ring ellipse layer active by clicking on it. After that, select horizontal type tool and then select any font of your choice. For this, I will be choosing a Times New Roman font, which is default in the Photoshop. Now after that, let me just find the vertical center of this document. So for that, press Ctrl plus R and then drag from the vertical to the center of the document. So now this looks proper. So now as you can see that the path of the circle is completely visible. Now let me just zoom into this document in order to show it to you. So as you can see a line over here, that is the path of the circle. Now after that, using the type tool, you have to click on this path, which will let you type the text in the form of this circle. Now after that, we need to place this text at the center. So for that, press Ctrl and drag this dot over here at the center. So as you can see, as you drag this dot, it drags the whole text. After that, click on this tick icon to place it. Now you can do the same thing for the bottom over here as well. So for that, again make the inner ring layer active by clicking on it. And then let me just zoom into the image and then click on the path and then type in your text. After that, press Ctrl and drag that dot at the center. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. So now as you can see, we have placed the text inside of the ring over here. Now let me just drag this two text layer inside our text group layer. After that, we need to remove the dotted circular portion where the text is present. So for that, select pen tool and then using pen tool, create a path where you want to remove the circular dotted portion. So once the path is ready, after that, make the ring dotted group layer active by clicking on it. And then right click inside of the path and then select option make selection and then click on OK. After that, click on add layer mask icon and then press Ctrl plus I to invert the mask. Now create a path for the bottom over here as well. After that, right click inside of the path and then select option make selection and then click on OK. After that, set the foreground color as black and then click on OK. And then press Alt and Backspace key of your keyboard to remove that portion inside of the selection. After that, press Ctrl plus D to deselect the selection. So now as you can see, our logo is now ready. Now let me just remove this ruler. After that, press Ctrl plus R. After that, inside of the swatch over here, I want to type in the year at which the company was established. Now after that, make the text group layer active by clicking on it. And then create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. After that, select horizontal type tool and then select any font of your choice. I'm selecting Times New Roman for a year as well. And then set any appropriate size. After that, set the foreground color as white. And then click on the document and then type in your text. But over here, I want these dots to be placed at the center of the text. So for that, make a selection of it. And then increase the baseline shift to 10 pixels. So as you can see now, the dot has been placed at the center. Do the same thing for the second dot over here. And then click on this tick icon to place it. After that, we need to add stroke over here as well. So for that, click on add layer style option and then select option stroke. After that, set the size of the stroke as 8 pixels. Position as outside, blend mode as normal, opacity to 100% and color as same as background color and then click on OK. After that, select move tool and then using move tool, place it inside of this swatch over here. Now do the same thing which we had done for the stroke of the text over here. So now as you can see, we have our logo ready. Now if you want to change the color of the background, then all you need to do is double click on this color fill option and then change it to any color of your choice. After that, click on OK. Now if you want to save this logo with a transparent background, then all you need to do is hide this color fill layer and then hide the background layer. After that, save this image as a PNG. Now after that, you can drag that PNG image into other images if you want to use it as a watermark. So let me just revert it. So that's it guys, this will give you a simple and creative text logo in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.